Hey girls, how are you doing? Right, tonight I want to talk to you about something that I'm going to be titling The Race to the Top. And I listened to a speech on Sunday and it really hit home to me about a lot of things connecting to our business. So I thought I would jot this down, write as many notes as possible of what I could remember and put it into training for you because it's so exciting. And I'm hearing a lot of you saying, wow, last month was amazing. You know, I really did so well. The team was on fire. I was on fire. We got really high. And then this month it's like, poof. And I wanted to talk to you about that because it's okay. And I feel like that, you know, it's natural. And I'm just going to try and explain a little bit. And I've wrote my notes, so excuse me if I'm not going to be looking into the camera all the time, but I'm going to be reading my notes as well. So this business is like a race. And as you run your race, you've got to throw away anything that will hinder or slow you down. You really do not need any negativity while you run this race. And understand that it is a long race. And it's going to require endurance and it's going to require perseverance. And you need to keep your eye on that goal. And you also need faith. You need a lot of faith. So the simple question that I'm going to ask you is, if I had to sit down and interview you, how is your race going? For some of you, you might immediately say, I'm going strong. There is times in our business, everything is going well. You're selling, you're sponsoring, you're networking, you're getting great feedback. Everything is clear, you're focused, you're passionate, you have meaning, your business is thriving. If you're here today and everything is going well and strong in your business, that is a wonderful place to be. It doesn't mean that it's easy, but you get a feeling of peace and joy. And I know it isn't easy, but everyone is encouraging you, you're doing well and well done. I am so, so pleased for you. Maybe some of you would say, going strong? No. That's maybe not where I am. Maybe some of you would say, if I'm honest, I'm slowing down. I'm slowing down my race. And this could be due to a number of reasons why you may slow down in your race. Sometimes it's just because you're tired, you're fatigued. Maybe you're watching this and you've just come through a really busy patch. You've been working hard. You felt like you've been climbing a really steep hill. And you've been working long hours. You've been running really fast and maybe just a little too long and you just feel exhausted. And when you're exhausted, it's hard to go strong. And you start to slow down a little and you need rest. And you kind of need to have a really, like, don't drink of water and refuel for the next part of your journey. And that's probably what's happened to a lot of you. You know, last month you were just going for it. And you just need a little bit of rest and that's okay. You know, I understand this. The world was designed to have a rhythm, a balance of activity and rest. You work, then you take time off. All of nature, all of the world is built around the rhythm. The sun rises and then sets. The tide goes out and then goes in. We breathe in, we breathe out. Imagine if you breathed out all day. It wouldn't be a good day, would it? You have to breathe in and breathe out. There is a rhythm of engagement and disengagement, activity, then rest. If we put your heart on one of those ECG machines, you would have a rhythm like this. But if your heart was flat like this, it's not going to be a good year for you, is it? And so all of the world, not just your business, it has a rhythm and a balance about it. So sometimes when you're working really hard and you're going full place and you're tired and you're exhausted and you're slowing down in your race, it's actually normal because you need to refuel. And that's why holidays are important. That's why a day off is important. That's why recreation is so very valuable. You know, we've got this silly story, but it relates, it does. We've got this coffee and tea machine downstairs where you just press a button and it makes it for you. But it needs water put in the back of it. And nobody wants to do that job, nobody. And you know, there's teenagers in my house that drink so much tea, like loads of tea, crazy. And you know, me and my husband. And when that thing runs out of water at the back, it will not work. It says, fill me with water. You know, and you have to, it won't make any tea, it won't make any coffee. You have to take it to tap and fill it up with water for it to work again. So maybe you are in a fill me with water state. You need to refuel to work again. You're tired. Sometimes you might slow down, not because you're tired, but because you're uncertain. And you're coming up to an intersection or a new road and you haven't been down this road before. You know, if you're a smart driver, when you are uncertain, hopefully you're not in fifth gear. I hope you're not. But you slow down because it's new and you need to go a little bit slower because it's all unfamiliar. So be patient with yourself. You're learning parties, you're learning sponsoring, you're learning our products. It's all new for some of you. And you may be slowing down because you're learning and you're getting your bearings before you speed back up again. And that's okay. And then sometimes we slow down because we've lost our passion. And slowing down is not because we're tired. It's not because we're uncertain. We're actually just cruising and coasting. You're here, but you're just going through the motions. And that level of passion is diminished and maybe a little bit disillusioned. And it's become comfortable and complacent. And that flame of enthusiasm inside of you has taken a hit. You know, you want to light that fire inside of you again. You want to find that passion inside of you. I want to encourage you to watch that and don't live below your potential. It's easy to become comfortable and it's easy to just cruise, but you could be living below your potential. And if you just light that fire again, get that enthusiasm you had when you first started, get that passion, you could really excel and succeed. So just watch that. Watch if you're just cruising and comfortable. And there'll be some of you watching this that, if you're honest, may say, I think I kind of have stopped in my race. And some of the things that can cause you to stop is tragedy. We all go through it. You know, you could experience death. Maybe your spouse has left you. Maybe your kids are really worrying you. Maybe your teenager you caught doing drugs. Whatever, you can identify to all of these. But when that happens in life, your life feels like it's stopped, let alone your business, you know. And maybe that's where you are today. And it's okay. You have to take that time out when things just get too much. Sometimes you stop because of failure. You know, you trip up for some reason, you take a tumble, you fall down. And if you've ever fallen down, you know it's embarrassing. And if you ever fail, it feels shameful when you fail. You know, you think, oh, I didn't get that colour promotion you wanted. But trust me, you know, you have to continue with your race to get there. You will get there. It took me, I hit green in July 2015, and it took me 3 attempts, my fourth attempt, I got it. But to me, 3 attempts before that, each month I went for it, missed it, missed it, missed it. Sometimes I missed it just, sometimes I missed it by a couple of thousand, but I missed it. And I run. And I really did do a few months like that. Like, and as soon as I hit it in July, I was like, woo! And I didn't hit it again the next month. You know, I finally hit it and then I didn't hit it again. But then I took that month off because I was like, oof. And then in August, I didn't hit it. But September, poof, back I went and hit it again, you know. And then I think the next month, I didn't hit it again. October, and then November, we hit it again. And then we've hit it every single month since. So once we, you know, I started to build. It's not an easy jump to go from green to orange. But I started to build, I started to spend 2 months building and building everybody, building my team, helping people, you know, teaching everything that I could and sponsoring more. And I thought, right, let's have another go. Let's run for orange. And last month I had a run for orange and I didn't get it. But I tell you what, I had the best month ever in my life with Unique. And that's amazing. Like, I had the highest paid month I ever had. I had the best month. I had girls getting promotions. It just was brilliant. And even though I didn't hit orange, it was just an amazing month and the best month I ever had. So You know, I've failed loads of times in getting what I want. I can't tell you the amount of times I've gone for a colour and didn't get it. But just for example, last month, when I really went for a colour and didn't get it, it didn't matter because I still had the highest month I ever had. So I hope my story encourages you, you know. And success is never about failing. It's about getting up and continuing your race after failure, rather than wallowing in self-pity, thinking that your race is over. Who knows what's around the corner from you? You just have to keep going. And do not worry if you've had like a mega month and then, you know, when you failed, one of the things that I like to do is ask myself, like, did I do everything I could possibly do? And the only one time I could honestly answer yes to that in my whole 14 months I've been with Unique was last month. I did everything I possibly could. I got my PRS to 2,700 in personal sales. I had parties coming out my ears. I had a really happy, supportive team. Like, everybody did everything right. And that's only one time I could honestly answer that out of the whole 14 months. And what proves that I did do everything is, as well, I had the highest month ever, the best month ever. And that's because I did everything. But all those other months that I've gone for colours, you sit there and it's only you, so you can be honest, and you say, did I do everything I could possibly do? And a lot of the time, the answer is no. No, you know, oh, I only had 4 parties booked in. Oh, I only made 400 in sales, you know. Oh, you know, when you're ever going for a promotion, you need to really have the highest sales you can possibly get. There's been, and this is where I go back the rhythm again, you know, there has been months, I don't very rarely get under 1,000, but I've been under 1,000 for about 4 times, maybe 4 or 5 times. There's been some two months where I was under, I think, 600, which is very unlike me. But it's all about going like this. You know, that's what I said. It's okay. You cannot always be going up. Another way that I like to look at things is think of yourself as a plane taking off. You know, well, you need to get that plane and you need to put it in a full throttle gear to get the momentum to go take it off. And do that for your whole month to get really high up in the sky. But what happens if you don't take it out of full throttle? One, you're going to orbit out of the earth, burn up, whatever. Or your engine's going to burn out. You're going to have to take it up. And then you're going to have to just coast for a little while, you know. If you want to go up a bit higher the next month, then you can go full throttle again. But then you're going to have to coast. So I'm telling you, I have been in all of those positions. You know, I have been slowing down. I've been full pace. I've actually even stopped. I have lost my passion some months. I've said, well, you know, oh, is this worth it? I have been there. And the great news is every single month, you've got the ability to change it. You can just start a fresh month with Unique. You know, you could have the most rubbish this month ever, and then the next month you can decide, right, that's it, I'm going for it. And you could have the best month ever. So, you know, the month is only roughly about 30 days long. So the great news is you can change it. And no matter where you are in your race, you're always going to have your sponsor behind you. You're always going to have your upline, and you're always going to have me. We're all going to be cheering you on, and we're all here for support. There's so much training. You know, we've got files on Makeup Queens. If you can't sleep one night, do your research, you know, read up on the files. Watch the videos, take notes, do what you need to do. You know, I can't pull you, I can't take you to the top, but I can give you the tools you need, and I could give you advice, and it's all here for you. If you want it, you can get it. You just need to take the tools and use them. So please don't beat yourself up if you're having a slow month, and just realise that it's normal. And think, you know, April 1st, let's have another go. Let's start again. Do what I do, you know. Just take a break and then go for your next race. I'm living proof that you can do this. And I'm living proof that you can get through all of these stages in your race, whether you're going strong, whether you're slowing down, whether you've lost your passion, whether you've stopped. It's okay. Next month is a new month. Anyway, that I hope that I've reached out, and I hope that, you know, I've inspired some of you tonight. I've made you feel a bit better. You know, I've done a lot of training for the newbies recently. I think this one is for people that, you know, have been with Unique a little while. And I'm always behind you. You've got all the tools here. And I hope to see you racing next month. And I hope that we can celebrate your successes at the end of April. It would be amazing to see and hear that this video had helped you and inspired you, and then you turn around and promote. I'll probably be a bag of like tears and like soppiness. But anyway, have a good evening, girls, and I love you loads. Thank you for watching.